Alright, so tell me your favorite thing about LA so far.
The weather. Coming from Chicago, like, it's super obvious. We have some of the worst winters in Chicago, so I'm really looking forward to no winter. And just the sunshine. I got a little sun-kissed and everything. I love the weather in LA. That's definitely...
What part are you in right now?
I'm in North Hollywood.
North Hollywood,
yeah. Yep, my tattoo studio is there, so I've been just out there working, you know, grinding and enjoying it. Really, but I feel like because I'm a tattoo artist, it's kind of like, you know, the same thing anywhere I go. Like, here the vibe is great. Chicago, the vibe is good. LA, the vibe is good. You know, it's not like I'm switching jobs. You know what I'm saying? So it's pretty cool, though. I love it.
What about Atlanta? How you love Atlanta?
I love Atlanta. It's so artsy here. Like, the art scene in Chicago, I don't feel like is as popping as it is in Atlanta. I was in an all-women's art show on Thursday. That's actually the reason that I'm out here for A3C. And there were just so many other talented women. Like, I couldn't believe it. So that's just very inspiring. Even before the cameras came, you know, we were a very, very tight-knit, you know, family. And, you know, I guess on TV you don't get to see how we really hold each other down in real life. You know what I mean? Ryan has come to terms with me leaving. You know, he knows I'm always going to be a part of the family. Just because you move out the house doesn't mean they're not your family anymore. So, yeah, and I think everybody is really expanding and just, you know, doing what we're supposed to. Like, you take this group of young black individuals and you put them on TV, you know, with the talent to showcase. And everybody is really trying to capitalize off of it. Four is a great rap artist, you know what I mean? He's taking his music to the max. Van has been working on his brand, Chicagorilla, for the longest, taking that to the max, you know? My Kat Tat, my paintings, my artwork, my apparel, like, we're just doing what we're supposed to. So it's a huge blessing. I'm more prepared. Okay, so first season, I'm not going to lie, I read every single comment that somebody posted on my page or on Facebook or on Twitter. Like, I would really read it, you know what I mean, and really care about people's perception. But after, you know, being in it for a while, I realized that people are going to talk. You could do something great, people are going to talk. You could do something terrible, people are going to talk. So it's like, we filmed the show, it's over with. Just, you know, enjoy the television that you're watching, because that's all it is entertainment. So,
well, tell me how it is being a woman in this tattoo artistic entertainment, surrounded by guys all the time.
Yeah, definitely.
Assume a male tattoo artist all the time.
Yeah,
I'm a beautiful, creative woman.
Yeah, I'm so grateful that I have this platform, because I know what it's like to be a woman in this industry, and I know how I was when my work wasn't that good. And I know that the struggle that I had trying to become a great artist in this industry. So I'm so thankful that the TV show came along when it did, because it came along at a time when I was really proud of my work and when I really worked hard for everything that I have. I worked hard to work with these guys and, you know, do everything that I do. So I'm grateful that people can look at me and see that, you know, despite a male-dominated industry or whatever it is, if you have your eyes set on something, you can do it. And nothing can really, you know, knock you off of that. If you're focused, just stay focused. And I'm happy to represent for the women. Like, there's so many women that are my age, younger, older, that are killing it. And they might not go notice, you know what I mean? Because people think that it is a male-dominated industry when it's not. Women are killing it just as much.
So what advice do you have for young, up-and-coming artistic women?
My best advice, especially speaking from my experience, is once you find something that you want to do, stick to that. Stick to that and put your all into it. Put your heart into it. I had to, you know, make the sacrifice to leave school alone when I was studying math, just to put my heart into tattooing, because I knew it was something that I wanted to do.
So that would just be my advice. You're going to have plenty of distractions, but as long as you stay true to what you're trying to do and, you know, just stay focused, and it'll take you a long way.
You're amazing. Thank you so much for taking this time for me.
Okay. Hey, it's Kat Tat from Black Ink Crew Chicago, and I'm here with Rolling Out.